We want to solve the compound inequality and then express the solution using interval notation. Our compound inequality consists of two inequalities connected by the word or, which means the solution will consist of all of the values that satisfy this inequality as well as all the values that satisfy the second inequality. So we're going to solve and graph both of these and then graph both solutions on the same number line to interpret the results. So we'll first solve the inequality 2x minus 10 is less than negative 14. And then we'll solve the inequality negative 3x plus 2 is less than negative 10. So to isolate x on the left side here, we'll start by adding 10 to both sides of the inequality. This would be 0, so we have 2x is less than, this would be negative 4. And now we'll divide both sides by 2. Now we're dividing by a positive, so we do not reverse the inequality. It's only when multiplying or dividing by a negative that we reverse the inequality symbol. Negative 4 divided by positive 2 is negative 2. So now we'll graph x is less than negative 2 on the number line. Again, since negative 2 does not satisfy this inequality, it's not in the interval, so we make an open point at negative 2. And then for numbers less than negative 2, we have an arrow to the left. And now we'll go ahead and solve the second inequality. So we'll start by subtracting 2 on both sides of the inequality. This would be 0, so we have negative 3x is less than, this would be negative 12. And now we'll divide both sides by negative 3. Remember, when we divide by a negative, we do have to reverse this inequality symbol. So here we have x, but then it's going to be greater than, and negative 12 divided by negative 3 is positive 4. Now let's go ahead and graph x is greater than 4. Again, 4 does not satisfy this inequality, so it's not in the interval. So we have an open point on 4, and then for numbers greater than 4, we have an arrow to the right. And because we have an or, which means union, the solution to this inequality would consist of the interval on the left as well as the interval on the right. So the solution would be x is less than negative 2 or x is greater than 4. Now to express this interval using interval notation, we need to remember that as we move to the right of the number line, we would approach positive infinity. If we move to the left of the number line, we approach negative infinity. So notice how we have two intervals. The first interval here will have negative infinity and negative 2. It's open on negative 2, so we have a rounded parenthesis here as well as on negative infinity. Or we have the interval from 4 to infinity. It's open on 4, meaning it does not include 4, so we have a rounded parenthesis here as well as to the right of infinity. And sometimes instead of using the word or, you'll see textbooks use U for union, which looks like this, which would be the same thing as using or. I hope this explanation helps.